channel. What's up?
Hey guys, so it's Savannah. Welcome back to my channel. Today we are doing something that I've actually never done before and was an idea given to me by you guys. I wanted to switch things up on my channel a little bit. I constantly do song suggestions and I constantly do drive with me's, and even though those videos are never ever going anywhere, I do want to kind of add a little bit of a variety into my channel, and I thought today's video would be pretty interesting and pretty funny. So for today's video, I asked you guys on Twitter, which if you don't follow me on Twitter, you definitely should. It's kind of like the easiest way to get in contact with me. I'm constantly checking Twitter all the time. I'll put my Twitter handle right here. You should go follow it. But I asked you guys on Twitter to DM me your deepest, darkest secrets, your confessions, your scandalous things that you would not want anyone else to know. I asked you to send them in to me because I am going to be reacting to them today anonymously, of course. I got exposed yesterday, so I think it's only fair for everyone else to be exposed a little bit too. So yeah, so for today's video, I'm going to be going through some of your guys' DMs that you sent me and see what you guys are hiding from the rest of the world. If you want a part two to this video, let me know. Leave it in the comments and that will definitely happen. But without further ado, let's just get right on into it. Let's see how savage you guys really are. A few years ago, my ex and I were hooking up in a parking lot after our high school game. I cheered and he played football, and a cop pulled up and had us get out of the car, and I had my cheer uniform on and he had his football jersey on, and the cop literally made fun of us saying, "Y'all are idiots, get a hotel room, it's more fun. You can do a lot more kinkier stuff." Ew. So like, I'm not sure if he thought we were doing roleplay or what, but luckily we were seniors and we were 18, so we didn't call our parents. Oh, cause he thought like the high school, like the cheerleader and the football was like costumes. But I don't like how the cop was like, "You can do kinkier stuff." Why would you say that? Why? At least you didn't get arrested. I went to a party a few weeks ago and ended up hooking up with this dude, and the next morning before he left, he gave me a high five and walked out the door. He went and ghosted me the next day. If someone gave me a high five, I'd take their hand and break it. I'm so sorry. You deserve better than a high five. Right after me and my boyfriend broke up, his buddies kept on hitting on me. I just found that funny because whenever a girl and a guy break up, his friends are always the ones to hit her up. Anyway, so I was like, "Don't be petty, don't do it," but my ex had cheated on me and I caught him at her house.
God.
Y'all deserve better than this. And I called him and was like, "Hey, where are you?" And he was like, "I'm at my house." And I was like, "Nah, bitch, I'm outside her house and your car's here, so come out."
Savage.
Savage. "I'm not going to." And then I was like, "Okay, cool, tell her to come out." And he was like, "No, leave." But keep in mind, I paid for his car because my car was kind of small and we kind of needed a big car. So I took everything I bought for the car, including the radio and the insurance card and steering wheel cover. Took a Chick-fil-A sandwich he had in his car, smeared it all over his car and windows and handles. And by that time, he was already outside. I took lemonade that was in the car and I literally dumped it on him. And then after the news got around, we finally broke up. Literally everyone wanted us to break up because they kept saying I was too hot and smart for him. Sounds like it. His friends started asking for a shot or if we could hook up. I finally said fuck it and yes, and did it, and all of them literally posted me on their story, and he was pissed, and his mom told me he cried all day after he found out I started to see other people. And to this day, no one knows what happened. They just know we broke up. You're a savage. Like, you live up to this family fucking name. But here's my thing about like revenge. I totally feel you on that because like, I'm definitely the type of person that's like, if I get revenge on you, you don't necessarily have to know about it. I'm just gonna do it. Like, it's a mental note in my mind. If you only knew type of thing. Like, if you want to fuck me over, if you want to like say shit, it's kind of like in the back of my mind, like, if you only knew. Wow. Savage. You guys are no chill. When I was in middle school, 9th through 10th grade, making YouTube videos was huge in my school, and I always wanted to make singing videos. And let me tell you, I can't sing to save my life. However, I didn't think anyone would notice if I took videos of me lip singing to covers that Ariana Grande did back in the day and played it off like it was actually me. That's brilliant. Well, people believed it, and everyone in my school was astonished by what a great singer I was. So much so that they secretly signed me up for a talent show, thinking I'd be so excited to get my talent out there. I literally could not talk my way out of it no matter how hard I tried. Teachers were excited, my classmates were excited, my singing videos were going around the school, so I show up to the talent show and my mom had me make the confession in front of the entire audience as a punishment to not lie or take credit away from others. Definitely learned my lesson because it was mortifying. Sometimes if I run into people that knew me back then at a bar or something, they'll be like, "Oh, hey Ariana," as a joke. Thank God we can all laugh at it now, but it was one of the worst days of my life back then. That sounds mortifying. Good Lord. Your mom was not having any of your shit. That would be so bad. Oh, that would be so bad. I'm so sorry that happened. I made a fake Snapchat account to catch my ex cheating, and my four best friends at the time helped me look sexy and helped me take pictures to send him of my body, and he ended up sending down their picture, and he's never found out since. What?
He's never found out that she made a Snapchat. That Snapchat's fake.
Oh!
Fucking savage.
Bro.
It's so funny.
Confession, I have an unhealthy obsession with One Tree Hill. Like, seriously, I need help. No.
You guys don't understand.
I'll just tell you guys a little story, okay? Because I think we're on this level now. You think you have an unhealthy obsession with One Tree Hill? Sit down, I'm gonna tell you a little quick story time. So, I was seeing this guy one time, right? So, we were seeing each other one time, we were hanging out, you know, we were drinking a little bit, and one thing leads to another, and we're like kind of having this like serious conversation, like a serious talk, and for whatever reason, mind you, I don't know anyone by the name Clay. Not a single person in my life do I know is named Clay. I don't know anyone named Clay. And if you know One Tree Hill, you know that there's a character that comes in at like season 5 named Clay, and he stays for like the duration of the series. I look at this kid whose name is nowhere near Clay, and I look at him and I start calling him Clay. And he's getting so mad. Like, he is livid. At the time, I didn't understand, like, why he was getting mad. So I kept being like, Clay, what's wrong? And he kept looking at me like, are you fucking serious? And, like, stormed off. I mean, we made up and we were fine. But, moral of the story, you think you have an unhealthy obsession with One Tree Hill? Until you're calling other people the One Tree Hill character names, I think you're chilling.
I'm a witness of this.
She was there. My best friend is cheating on her boyfriend with my brother, who is married. She's 18 and he's 28. I tried telling them because I don't fuck with cheaters, but I guess they'll believe me when they find out she's pregnant. And even though he's my brother and she's my best friend, they're both pieces of shit.
My God.
Oh boy. Looks like you've got yourself into a little situation. Or not you, but they did, and you're kind of in the middle. I got caught masturbating by my grandma. Oh, that's rough. How do you even explain that? I wouldn't know what to say. What do you even say at that point? Hey, what's up? I really hope you don't judge me too hard for this. First of all, you guys, major disclaimer, I have no room to judge anyone, nor would I even ever judge you guys. My senior year of high school, I converted to be a Mormon so I could try and get with my best friend's brother, going to extreme lengths. I feel that. Since they were super into religion and they would only marry people within their religion. Then he ended up getting married and I realized being a Mormon was everything I didn't live for. Haha, my name's still in the church and the missionaries did still try to come back to the door to get me back to church until one day they came and I answered the door super drunk and blah. Super drunk and obnoxious, and they haven't come back since. That's one way to get rid of them. I would have taken that approach too, honestly. So, one day, this guy that I had been with for basically the whole summer played me real good and fucked with this girl who had told me he was his cousin,
okay,
and tried to hide it. So, I went over to his house and fucked his stepbrother while he was home, then acted like nothing happened for a good couple weeks until I finally just cut that fuckboy off and moved on. Savage! I love that. I think that's brilliant, honestly.
Oh, you.
I would have totally done that too, though. Confession, my fiance cheated on me and left me for his best friend's sister. So a couple months after that, I fucked his roommate, who is his other best friend. You guys don't play. You guys do not mess around. I love it. I'm proud. I'm genuinely proud. I think the Savage family is like the perfect name for us because I think you guys have definitely proven yourselves to live up to that name. And I love it. I think it's brilliant. I think it's so great. All right, you guys, that was the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed it. As always, all of my links are going to be at the end of this video and in the description box below. If you're new to my channel, hi, my name is Savannah. I make videos 3 days a week, Sunday, Tuesday, Thursday. You should subscribe, join the family. I love you guys so much, and I'll be back in a couple days with a brand new video for you. And yeah, I'll see you guys soon. Bye.